Hi, well, in this video we're going to be looking at how to change all of the colors of a chart into a single color, and that color is the background that's in cell 1-1 on sheet 1. And so we're just going to go ahead and dig right into it. Now, this is part of a chart series where this is where we're changing all of them, and then we actually go back in the upcoming videos and we'll actually color these according to whatever their background color is here. It's a great way to impress your boss because you can put your company's name in a different color, you can put your competitors in a different color. So without further ado, let's dig in. So the first thing we're going to do is we've got a scratch pad open. You'll notice that I do have this, and I will make this available on my blog. But we're going to just do sub scratch. We're going to call this color all. Now the first thing we're going to do is we are going to declare a chart object, which is chrt. That's what we're going to call it, as chart. Easy peasy. Now we're going to set that chart equal to sheet one dot chart objects. We're going to do the first chart object, and we're going to do it needs to be a dot, not a comma, and everything capitalized, so we probably are good to go. The next thing we need to do is we need to grab the color from that cell. So I'm just going to use a nameless variable here. We're going to go equals sheet one dot cells 1-1. This is also range A1, and that's going to be interior color dot color. And if we grab this, I'll just show you what this does. If we copy this, it's going to give us a number, and I'm going to use my immediate window, put a little question mark. Enter that color, this blue right here, happens to be, that's the number of the color. Now I'm just going to do a quick copy and paste because we do need to get this into RGB for the chart object. And so there it is. And so we're turning getting the red portion, getting the green portion, getting the blue portion, and we are good to go. Now what we need to do is do a loop. So we're going to go for C, which is going to be my variable for my loop. Equals 1 2 chrt dot series collection, which I'm going to do series collection 1 dot points dot count, and that's going to count the number of points in that series collection. So I'm going to hit next, and let me show you what the series collection is. The series collection is Toyota, Volkswagen, Hyundai. That each one of those represents a point. So now all we need to do is pretty easy. We're going to go chrt dot series collection dot one, and if I'm making this look easy, it was not. Actually took quite a bit of time figuring this one out, but it's easy to do this in a video and show you how to do it because I've kind of spent hours on this trying to figure it out. So we're gonna go four color dot RGB is equal to RGB. So what we've got here is we've got a simple little macro here that goes and grabs the color, this background color. It grabs it, it converts that into R, G, and B. And then what we have is we've got a loop that goes through every single point of series one. Now this only has one series because it doesn't pull in the top 15%. But if we run this, I'm gonna put a little stopper here, and I'm going to hit F5, and it's going to stop right there. And you'll notice when I hit F5 again, it's going to turn Toyota from that red to the blue, if I did it right, which it looks like I did not because I called it point instead of points. Let's give that another go. Look, it's working. So you just change Hyundai, and you'll notice it just changed Ford. It's actually changed Nissan, even though you didn't see it. It's going to change Honda, and then the rest are blue. So our code is working exactly as expected. So let's just double check it real quick, and let's do one little thing. Let's actually turn this, change the color to gray, and I actually got the hyperlink right here, and it is working like a charm. So that is how you go and change all the colors in a chart to a single color. In the next video, what we're going to do is we're actually going to show you how to check for these and change this Change that color. It's the color table. We get the colors from the table. That'll be the next video, followed by the loop sheet and chart object, the loop series connection, and then we will do a total code walkthrough. Hope you enjoyed.